Joining me in the commentary booth then is of course going to be Lethal Wiz. Lethal Wiz.
Thank you. I'm here.
I'm scared to say you've got a huge fan base, but it does seem to be a huge male fan base down there.
Well, they are some friends of mine and I enjoy their applause. Thank you.
Alright, so happy to have you here, and obviously you did play in the tournament. You actually came up versus one of the players, it was Nabbe, in the quarterfinals. Obviously, we know from that result, the fact that you're commentating, it didn't go too well for you, but how did you enjoy the tournament?
I really did enjoy the tournament. This is my first time at DreamHack, and I had a great time, and I mean, just, you know, playing Nabbe in the quarterfinals was a great end for me for this tournament in itself, and I mean, Nabbe didn't have that big of a problem defeating me, but still I put up a good fight, and I think Nabbe will put up a really good fight against LocKtar.
Yeah, LocKtar says he's going to take it in three. Does he believe this, or is he just smack talking?
A bit of both, to be honest. Well, LocKtar is really good at this point, but Nabbe is a sneaky bastard, so we'll see how this ends.
So, really good versus sneaky bastard.
Mm-hmm,
There's a movie in there somewhere. there's a kung fu film. Nabbe actually does seem, he seems a little bit, you know, always passive in his interviews. He seems, you know, very kind in a way. He seems modest, and, you know, he doesn't seem to want to ooze this confidence that his opponent does. LocKtar, do you think this is going to, you know, kind of play out in game? Do you think that LocKtar is going to be aggressive, Nabbe is going to be working around and being sneaky? Is that how they kind of play as well?
I think it, like, yeah, as you say, it kind of reflects the way they play as well. They are, I mean, Nabbe is more mellow in that sense, and his play style is a bit more careful. Well, I'd say, still, LocKtar is the favorite, but I also say that Nabbe has a really good spot, right, and he's a good chance to actually do some damage to LocKtar, and as long as he keeps away from Aerowalk, which we don't know as of this point, but that might be his weak point for Nabbe, and actually LocKtar has improved a lot on that map lately, so.
And does LocKtar have, you know, any other weaknesses apart from obviously that one map? I mean, is he looking stronger? Say, I mean, it looks like we're on DM4 at the moment. Is this one, you know, an advantage to anybody?
No, well, LocKtar usually is worse on the so-called Kenya maps, but which is Aerowalk and CT and DM3. But as I said, he has improved a lot on those maps. But still, the weakness we might find in him is when he gets, you know, he goes on the offense. He sometimes, you know, forgets about tactics and gets carried away a bit. So we'll see if he handles that. Yeah,
right. you heard it. Who thinks LocKtar's the favorite? Who's here for LocKtar? There's three people. And you made noise for six, so well done. Who's up for the underdog of Nabbe? There we go.
Okay, there they go.
Well, I think everyone loves the underdog, but certainly it's going to be a big challenge for him, and maybe the LocKtar fans will start recruiting soon. And by the time we're in the third map, then we would have swayed the audience. But we are waiting for them to ready up, and you know, obviously we're going to see five maps, and it does look like LocKtar is actually ready. He says okay.
Mm-hmm.
So hopefully he's only Nabbe to ready up, and these guys do want to make sure they're you know, comfortable. They've only just sat down here, you know, they are at the Dream Arena. Extreme, obviously powered by Tidia, and they're going to want to be comfortable because, you know, just missing these crucial shots. I know that obviously Quake World is fast paced, and you can get a lot more chances actually compared to Quake Live, the new Quake. But you know, one missed shot could equal you just being, you know, terminated for the
Absolutely.
Next kind of 2 minutes, especially if you know, lose your position and, you know, DM4, we see people holding center room, crazy rockets, you know, mm-hmm. holding it heavy with the shaft as well. It can be devastating just not to be comfortable.
Absolutely. We saw some interesting mind game in the quarterfinals in the semifinals between LocKtar and BPS, where BPS wanted to play some POV DM4, which is one of those fast-paced aiming maps where you get to you know, feel your shaft a bit, and LocKtar actually denied him on that. So there are some mind games going on here. I absolutely think so.
And when he's ready, we know that this game will be on. And of course, best of five is first to three. And it does look like DM4 is going to be the map. And actually, I think someone said that DM4 times 3. I'm sure that's not going to be the case. But certainly, there's a lot of DM4 fans out there. But what makes DM4, you know, one of the kind of favorite maps of Quake World? Because it's kind of, I always find it almost unknown why a map works so well. But when it does, it just does.
Well, the thing about DM4 is that it's so fast-paced, and you get so many spawn frags on this map. If you get the upper hand here and you decide not to go for the red armor and stay out in the middle and just gamble for those spawn frags, you can get away with 10 spawn frags before actually dying. So,
and it does look like we are going to be going live then. We do have a countdown. We are going to have a track on. So it is going to be Nabbe versus LocKtar, and we are going to be in the match.
Nabbe got the red armor. Red armor spawn.
And there we go. Sorry to give you the game a little bit late. We couldn't actually see the countdown, but we are currently following Nabbe. He's holding center ground right now, and he's probably expecting, you can see there, LocKtar to be in that red armor room. LocKtar will want to take the red. He's going to have a hard time leaving this exit. There comes one Nay looking for a rocket combo on top of that. And LocKtar's playing very patiently. There he comes out. And that was perfect timing from LocKtar, because he escaped pretty cleanly, it seemed.
Yeah, LocKtar wanted to wait out that 20 seconds to get that armor for attacking.
And actually, LocKtar just dove in and actually got the mega. And Nabbe just took a rocket to the face already. And already he's going to be feeling the pressure of the DreamHack Summer Champ. He knows he's in the red armor room, expecting him to escape high. There comes a cover nade. There is armor going to be spawning that. Won't be picked up. And actually, LocKtar does make the first frag. Yeah, and he's already looking very, very comfortable. Nabbe escapes.
Well, funny thing is that Nabbe got the red armor spawn, but LocKtar, with his aggressive playstyle, actually managed to turn it around and got the upper hand, and now he's going for those spawn fights, as I mentioned earlier.
Yeah.
But Nabbe got that spawn at RA. I'm not sure if he got the red armor.
Yeah, so Nabbe looked like he possibly did get the red armor to put such a fight, and some great drawn kills from LocKtar.
Awesome. Yeah.
He's only... he's got 73 health, but no, oh my god, great defense, and now he knows he's going to climb that red armor, and he is dominating at the moment. Nabbe did pick up the LG center, still with LocKtar, 7-0, 1 minute 50 gone. We are playing a map of 10 minutes. Finds Nabbe and punishes him just before he can make it through the teleporter. I don't know if that's fake jumping to see if he can call him out.
Yeah.
But it was. And so far, is Nabbe just, I wouldn't say outclassed, but what does he need to do to come back into this? I know we've got a long time yet, but 9-0 down.
That's the thing. I've seen quite a lot of DM force, and I know this game is probably not over yet, because it usually looks like the opponent doing the spawn frags are in total control, but one stupid mistake, falling through the lava or something like that, and this whole thing could turn around.
Yeah, and every time he goes for the teleport, so that is a slight risk, so always a gamble, and that could give Nabbe an advantage back. Now, Nabbe's actually bunked himself back into that red armor room. It won't be spawning for him yet, but he will wait out on it, but that's going to allow LocKtar to pick up this mega. Mm-hmm. He is going to be slightly heavier stacked, but he needs to get position to defend versus Nabbe, and Nabbe is going to come out cleanly. You can see that, I thought he'd left, but it looks like he hasn't.
No, he's still there. Switch over to Nabbe for a while.
There we go.
We'll go with Nabbe here.
And that's a slightly disadvantaged fight, and he will almost escape into the mega room, but LocKtar says no. And finally, he picks up another frag, and we'll be covering very quickly the whole room. Yeah. I mean, LocKtar, he went in and took that yellow armor, came out very fast, and was available to kind of, lock down Nabbe from picking up like LG or really getting into a position where he could be dangerous. So, playing from a lower level.
LocKtar seems so comfortable on this map, And there, Nabbe got I think it's his first frag, actually, although it's still zero, actually.
Yeah, I think he actually got put into the lava once, but I think that's his second frag, but he does get another one, and it's a shotgun to counter. Currently with knockdown. There's a 200, nice. There's another one.
You know, great support standing there.
And right now, you say that he knew that Nabbe was standing there, so he's really onto what Nabbe is doing to try and come back into the game, but what does I mean, is Nabbe just coming up short every time it's a brick wall?
Well, at this point, he pretty much is. Because, as I said, LocKtar seems to be so comfortable here. He's, he knows exactly what to do, and Nabbe is probably doubting himself. At this point, he is kind of hopeless, you know, 17-1, and we're halfway through the game.
Yeah, and
there's no, I mean, there's no signs right now that Nabbe will actually turn this around.
Well, LocKtar said he was in good form, and at least we know he's not a liar.
Obviously, yes.
Replenishing some of his rocket ammo and health. Nabbe fires the rocket just stray, and actually LocKtar's going to pick up a different position, and that actually caught Nabbe out. He didn't realize that he swapped over side, and this is pure domination.
Spawn frags.
One and
that's
two.
That's what this map is all about.
Oh, there's finally two
nice
good
one.
Rockets from Nabbe. And a round of applause as the man got a lot to do.
Well, he's going to get his chance now to actually make some difference here.
I do think that maybe LocKtar would have... No, he didn't dive into that mega room. Still too dangerous of an option for him. He did take the red, though, before leaving.
Oh,
there's a nice rocket shot.
Yeah.
And it looks like, oh my god, the rocket pushes him down, and LocKtar picks up the frag.
He fell down.
And the rocket off the ceiling was what knocked Nabbe down as he was peering over the edge. And when it all looked like it was coming back for Nabbe, LocKtar says, well, actually, change of plan. 23-3. We are over half time. Shaft far more dominant than the rockets there of Nabbe. Little jump forward as well just to finish off. And very comfortable. There comes another kill. No spawn frags for him this time round though. Back instantly to the second center of the map. Nabbe gonna have to hit a good rocket. And he already knows. LocKtar plays. Ducks under one.
That's what we in Sweden call a good build.
I'm sure we have names for that in England as well, but maybe not for the kids on stream.
No.
Although, as you mentioned, Quake World, old game, played by a mature audience.
Old farts, I'd say.
Including Leap of Wiz.
Yeah, exactly.
Ah, almost an air rocket there from Nabbe onto LocKtar, but only just missed. He's down to 20 HP. There comes the kill from the rocket. 4-28. 24 frags to go.
Still, Nabbe needs to get some armor here to actually get something out of this.
Yeah, that's the red.
That's the red armor.
Finds LocKtar looking for health and does pick up the frag. Let's see if he can make any conversions of this. No spawn kills just yet. LocKtar in the red armor room. He's going to leave. Not sure if red armor was taken previously. Red armor spawn is it on the 25?
Radama spawn is each 20 seconds.
Every 20 seconds, yeah. They're slightly faster, so potentially could have been up, but I'm not sure if it was. Let's stay with Nabbe just for the moment. He does pick up a frag. He's left with only 56 points of HP. Now, he goes for the yellow. Red will be spawning in roughly 10 seconds, so you can see that he's keeping his back to there, but actually, LocKtar's LG is more powerful, and he's going to make the move over to the red, and if spawns aren't there and actually looking for a hack, and oh my god.
Nice.
Almost got it. Nabbe came through. And here's LocKtar, was the catchphrase.
Well, LocKtar really wants to give the audience something extra, and he always does.
31-6, another flag of the shaft. There comes the conversion.
Nice
down,
one.
Almost went in for the mega health, but actually is more concerned about cutting off Nabbe. And does once again. And what do you think Nabbe is thinking right now?
Well, I'd say he's pretty much given up, actually. But he wants probably to get some frags and a good period in this game. In this game, just to take it with him to the next
match. Game. Yeah.
So.
We'll
the funny
see.
Thing here was LocKtar, because any other player would usually go to the mega area and like hang out because he's in the lead, but LocKtar just wants to play on and have a good time, and that's what we like to see. And there you go.
There we go.
Another axe murder.
It's almost criminal here in a DreamHack. So don't take that back to your land seats, kids. 40-6. LocKtar looking for a rocket shot. Doesn't connect. Does find Nabbe down the bottom. And actually looked like he just caught him as he came through the teleporter. Nabbe potentially hurt. LocKtar still aggressive. Constantly just going. chipping away at Nabbe. 24 points of HP, needs to buff up. There's 25. Is he going to make his way out? We'll do actually nice rocket jump to a no mega room. Is there? There was no mega there, but does become the kill. Eventually kills himself in the process. A round of applause for Nocta killing himself there. And finally, Nabbe could have the last 30 seconds. Let's see if he can take a couple more frags. There's the red that he needs. Looking for a rocket damage explosion from the top. There comes the second one as well. And this is what Nabbe needs. He's only got 10 seconds left, but if he can kind of remain dominant, he could take this into the second map, as Lethal was said, and that could be important. And he will be picking up the last frag, so he says, well, I'm not down and out just yet. I know how to play this as well.
There you go.
But it's all a little too late, but still great showing from both of these players. LocKtar picks up the final rocket. 39-11. So next map, do you want to give us a little of an introduction of this one?
So this is DM6. Then this map, from my point of view, could be in anyone's favor. This is obviously Nabbe's choice of map, but I'd say they're both equally good on this map. Right. LocKtar, although, gets the better start here. And he gets the red arm as well, which is really crucial here.
Yeah, so red armor over there, and they are going to meet in the center. Actually, LocKtar actually rocketed himself there just off the pillar. And Nabbe, I'm not sure if he's made his way in, and he doesn't want to stay in the RA room. Now, obviously, LG is going to be here, and actually, LocKtar's going to drop down, but nice Nabe's going to trap him, and he's
really
going to pick up the
frag. Nabbe, actually, because he gets the lightning gun, which is really crucial on this map. With the lightning gun, he can stand up high and just out-chop his enemy.
Yeah, obviously that center room, easy to dodge rockets if you and also the pressure you put out with lightning gun could be huge. He is actually waiting out for that mega. He has picked it up. Rockets to spam, and actually he's now made his way into the RA room, and he's going to meet LocKtar, taking a huge amount of damage, but LocKtar makes use of the LG. He was hurt, down to about 38 points of HP. He's down to 3. There comes the double grenade, and Nabbe's going to go, well, you know, I think I'll have some of this RA room, and it won't be spawning for a little while. He's got about 10 seconds left, so he's going to have to spam some rockets. He's got to be aware of where LocKtar's going to be coming. LocKtar, if he challenges, potentially could be dangerous, but one good rocket would send him away, and red armor will be picked up cleanly from Nabbe as we keep a 2-2 scoreline. 1 minute 20 gone. We can imagine Mega has gone over to LocKtar. Has he got an LG? He has as well. Both of them have LG. That was going to be important, but LocKtar definitely won that fight. And now Nabbe, if he goes back into that RA room, he's probably going to find LocKtar. And in fact, LocKtar would have already picked it up, so he knows he's looking for a spam. There's one good rocket. Second didn't connect. And he's really got to play defensively here.
Nice,
not enough. And did he not expect to find him there? I mean, why was that a good move?
He knew that he was going for the mega area, obviously, so he waited him out with the teleport. Here is for LocKtar now is to deny Nabbe the lightning gun. And that's a classic teleporter frag.
Actually, one teleporter frag followed up by a kill. Two rocket kills, actually. And red armor will be spawning now, so Nabbe 5-3, definitely a different game from the DM4.
That teleporter has made some crucial frags in the past on this map, which BPS knows, for instance, who played in the semi-finals. And LocKtar gets another frag from the shot.
And look, just going to work with Nabbe here. He's there.
That's really good. Really good.
And he got the boomstick to play with. Well, he is going to go into the RO room. Nice little rocket jump up to collect. Finds Nabbe and can only imagine that he's probably picked up the LG, so he's still got some force to reckon with when they meet. But he is tracking Nabbe, goes aggressive, and one good rocket will send LocKtar up, and actually that won't allow him to kind of chase, and he did get hit down low. Red armor's going to be spawning. LocKtar spam two grenades, rocket jumps up, goes aggressive, and that rocket's going to end it for him. And Nabbe played absolutely fantastically, and we're just going to set up some enemy skins here just to make sure that we got you some invisible viewage, as I like to call it.
That what makes it easy to spot the enemy. This is what the players themselves play with usually. Often it worked too well though.
LocKtar now actually showing his team skin color, a pale blue.
Oh, and
there comes the second tally frag. It was from LocKtar this time round.
Oh, he equalized the cover price.
Good kill for the HP remaining. Does pick up the small health packs. Takes the 200 armor as well. The red getting hit by real good rockets there from Nabbe. But Nabbe did a huge amount of damage. I think his armor pack was up there, so he would have picked up weapons from that. And rockets, and he knows he could probably get in on this RA room, but he's given away Mega to do so. So in exchange for Mega for RA, LocKtar probably still at a small advantage. If he picks a better fight in center, which he looks like he is, Nabbe needs to hit a rocket.
Yeah,
he isn't going to do so.
Really good.
And LocKtar, you know, just made mincemeat there of Nabbe, and really he's going to claim RA room now. So what does Nabbe need to do to kind of keep the scoreline close? What tactic does he need to execute?
Well, the only thing at this point is LocKtar has control of the red armor area, I guess. Oh, and there we go. I was going to say that Nabbe needs to grab the Mega, the green armor, and the shaft to actually be able to battle out against LocKtar on this map.
Great work.
Red armor.
Oh my god, he finds one.
Go.
There's the spawn as well.
Yeah.
And red armor to the victor. And right now, Nabbe in the lead. We are just over half time. Only 5 minutes left remaining. Shaft pick up for Nabbe. He hasn't got the Mega. He sees spots LocKtar just at the top of the center. And LocKtar goes aggressive. And that was a cheeky move. That really caught Nabbe off guard. He's going to have to play really well defensively here until that red spawns. He hasn't picked it up yet. Now he's got it. And this time he's probably going to be a little bit more cautious about going into the center. And rightfully so, because he could have just ran into those rockets. We also put him once again onto the back foot, and armor will still, you know, kind of be to the back of Nabbe.
Nabbe has to decide now if he wants to battle out for the Mega, and obviously it looks like he doesn't want to. He wants to keep it safe.
He's got the lead. A 1 point lead. At least he knows that if he connects with a good first rocket, he could follow up some LG. And LocKtar is going to be below him. Grenade spamming up. That one was dodged. That rocket was dodged as well. RA still awaits to be picked up. Doesn't need to be collected, obviously, as he sits on 200.
No, he wants to put it there until
he fights.
And he used that to his advantage. You see, he lost that red armor in the battle, and he just picked it up and finished him off.
Yeah, that was almost a nice counter kill there from LocKtar, but he will be shut down. 32 points of HP, and still he pressures, and LocKtar could get a shot.
Nice.
And Nabbe will claim a lot of frags, and those frags are going to be crucial going into the later stages of the game. Now,
indeed.
He didn't stay for the red armor. He's actually backed away and gone for the Mega. So Nabbe played that one brilliantly, leaving that red up, allowed him to replenish his armor mid-fight, and then he just went to work with the shaft. Spots LocKtar. One rocket. Doesn't look like it was going to. Didn't connect. Still being a little bit aggressive here. If he makes his way in unnoticed, he can actually maybe camp out for the next red, but potentially that could give away Mega. Let's check over with LocKtar. He's actually called onto this.
And he has a shot.
And I don't think Nabbe is going to want to stay in this situation. This could be bad for him. This is the frag that LocKtar needs to make, but Nabbe comes
nice
up
one.
Top. 30 HP, 200 armor picked up after that fight, so that was 30 HP to the end, and it worked out well for him. 18 to 11. And actually, it's going to be 18 to 11.
Well, you can actually see how Nabbe seems more comfortable on this map than pretty much like LocKtar was in DM4.
Yeah, definitely the slower paced maps are playing, you know, in favor of Nabbe's style. It's, you know, he's making smart decisions. He's forcing, you know, I wouldn't say bad positions, but certainly he's able to pick the positions he wants. And actually, LocKtar rocket jumped up
really
and
nice
put a rocket
well.
Into the face of Nabbe. And, well, even though he's 8 frags down, moves like that is what he needs to do to get him back into the game. He's got to take a chance. He needs to go aggressive. And Nabbe is hugely stacked right now.
Exactly. That's what he's good at. So he should keep that up, absolutely.
So let's see how aggressive he can go. LocKtar will be taking this red armor. As you know, Nabe's got his back to his, but that's going to be his. LocKtar center map took a lot of damage with the shaft. That's going to delay his attack. And as the timer runs down, as we move into the last 1 minute 30, Nabbe just slowing this up and actually extending his lead is probably going to be the end, because at the moment, the fact that he's played it so slow, he's going aggressive. There comes another frag. And he's played this one brilliantly, but what do you think really has been the difference? What do you credit his win to here?
it looks like at this point, as I said, Nabbe seems much more comfortable on this map, and I think he's more comfortable and he has more routine than LocKtar has. And as you mentioned as well, that his slow play style and more methodical gaming style seems to pay off here.
Yeah, and certainly the 3-0 is not a premonition that came true.
No.
So at least we know LocKtar isn't psychic.
I think that's all spectators here want to see. I'm a more than 3-0 game. I guess most of them want to see 3-2 game.
Yeah, that's what we have in DreamHack Summit, where LocKtar came up trumps, but obviously Nabbe's going to be looking to get a title of his own.
Mm-hmm.
And he says he hasn't been playing much, and LocKtar's on form. He actually had like a kind of a show match, didn't he, in quakeworld, out of someone out of retirement. How did that one work out?
You mean the DreamHack Summit?
LocKtar, apparently, I read he was playing somebody who came out of quakeworld retirement for a one-on-one
well,
game.
If you were thinking about... Yeah, some guy called Jerry, who most Quake World players did not know that much of. To be honest, that was kind of a weird matchup because he was not that great of a dueler, so, but he pretty much crushed that guy, so.
Yeah, well, there we go.
Memorable.
He did crush that guy, and Nabbe is going to return the favor from the first map and pick up a pretty comfortable win, I have to say, and we are going to move on to the next map. And do you want to give us a quick introduction on this?
They are going to play them all five, so this time it's up for Aerowalk.
And this is the map that you say that, you know, is really...
This could be kind of funny, because both players, if this was like 6 months ago, they were both pretty bad at this map, to be honest. But LocKtar has improved a lot on this map, and Nabbe himself, he says himself that this is his worst map, so this should be in LocKtar's advantage.
Alright then, so we are going to go live then into map 3, so let's bring you back the game because we've only just got in, we're already 7 seconds in, and we are just going to make sure we get all our values right, and already you can see, unfortunately, you didn't miss the first frag, but Nabbe did manage to pick it up. Being strong right now, that's going to be the red, and sometimes a little bit dangerous to get to. You can be caught off guard, or if you get like kind of shattered or rocketed when you make it up there, it can be devastating. And I think a yellow armor is probably behind him if it's similar, or just in front of him, sorry. And there's also a mega health on this map as well.
Yeah, the mega health is crucial. Both players want to battle out for the mega health.
And where's the mega health located?
It's located on the ledge down at the mid room. So, red armor first, and then we're going to go for the mega, as you see there, which Nabbe picks up.
All right, so same place as the Quake 3, which I know and play. And already 4-1 for Nabbe, and almost making it 5 there. Look like he's almost connecting, and he's going to meet LocKtar. There's going to be an LG fight, and LocKtar.
From LocKtar.
That was absolutely insane to come out on top of that. Great dodging. He picked up the kill with only 4 points of health remaining. Managed to actually steal away some health before going back to the red, but he's a little bit weak on the health right now. I'm not sure when Mega will be spawning. It is going to be sometime soon. Mm-hmm. Nabbe knows that, you know, since he took it last and he got killed when it's probably going to be up, and it is up, and LocKtar is going to take it. And that's going to be huge because he's 4-0 down, but there's a big chance of a comeback. Nice rocket there from Nabbe. That stopped LocKtar's attack, and Nabbe is actually up near the red armor, and here comes where you can trap him. He does hit one good rocket and some shaft, and actually LocKtar finds himself. You know, all his attacks have been shut down pretty well, but that was a nice kill, 4-1.
Both these players have really good shaft aim, so, and that's really an advantage on this map.
Right now, LocKtar wanting to get that red armor, but going to be shut down, and actually that rocket and LG look like it connected. Mega is going to be up. LocKtar will claim once again. That's 2 megas back to back. And as you said, Lethal Wiz, that's one of the most, you know, probably the most important item on here, because not as much health as, you know, so normally the higher, most people will still manage to get an armor if someone takes one, so the health can make a big difference.
Really, absolutely, and especially since if you manage to get the red armor and then get the mega, then you're really set.
LocKtar, so far just with the yellow. We will have another Mega soon, challenging Nabbe. Nice rocket up there. We'll hit the wall. Let's see if he goes aggressive. He does go aggressive. Is he going to pick up the kill? Nabbe would have taken the red. And LocKtar comes up trumps. And he brings us to a 2-point game. Spamming a rocket up just to kind of cover the exit. He is waiting for that Mega, it does seem, and he will go back to red in time when it is up.
It actually does catch Nabbe
heading over to the other side of the map. And that was the Mega pickup slightly earlier. Nabbe does look like he's probably got onto the red. I'm not sure if he did actually. No, he didn't. And LocKtar will take the red, and he is going to tie us up at 4-4. And a little bit of a change of pace here.
Well, LocKtar gets the red arm, and he's aiming for that Mega now. And if he gets it, he will probably gain that red advantage by gaining the fight on Nabbe. But Nabbe is really putting those rockets straight in his face, obviously.
Yeah, and actually, almost looked like he crated him from hitting a rocket on top of his head, and he did take the Mega LocKtar. Nabbe going aggressive, see if he can bully him off this red, and actually he does manage
really
to do
nice
so, and that is a very cheeky move, great move from Nabbe, and he's actually covering the yellow armor as well. He probably will rocket jump up. Oh my god. He will die in doing so. Two suicides so far for Nabbe, and that red armor still up, and you know, LocKtar's like, oh, thanks.
That frag up the stair from Nabbe is so hard to do. He's got a bunch of sharp in his face, and still just dodges it and goes up and puts three rockets in the LocKtar's face.
Nabbe playing the yellow, but nice LG from LocKtar will pretty much nullify it. Traps him. He's probably spawned over near the RA. Actually, he does find him top ledge. RA will be up. LocKtar to take, gonna have an advantage in this fight, looking to go aggressive, dodge one rocket, and there comes the kill, and that's all he's looking for. When he's got the advantage, he just wants to push, go aggressive, follow through. Nice air control there, although pretty standard for Quake World, I'm sure, but if anyone did that in Quake Live, they'd be kicked from the server. It's too skillful, you see. We can't have that in Quake Live. Another red pickup, 10-4. LocKtar has got the armor, but he's also got the height advantage, and Nabbe surely going to go down, but 5 HP. And there comes the counter kill. That was a good move.
Yeah.
11-5. LocKtar waits out for the red. There comes the kill. There comes the potential spawn, and slightly blessed there in that situation. Actually takes a shot just as he runs away with
he's
the boomstick.
He's only down to elf health, 8 health.
And I'm not sure if Nabbe would have picked up the Mega. Does it look like he has.
Yeah.
So Nabbe has pretty much got a small advantage here. I know that the health has been probably picked up by LocKtar. Let's switch back over to him. He has up to that 99 points of HP. Nabbe does have height advantage, which means if he makes a move into that red, he should be able to get it, but at what cost? Not sure if that rocket hit.
I think it did.
Or that LG hit.
And the armor that he did have is now gone.
LocKtar doing some creative moves.
Yeah. He's gonna head over to Red Armor now, Arena, because he knows that Nabbe's waiting for that one. And he has the yellow armor.
And actually, Nabbe looked like he almost had to leave, and they're trying to escape.
And
he's gotta be close to a kill. There comes
and
the kill.
Gets it.
Yeah, and LocKtar gets the Mega, which is too much, really, right now for Nabbe. And you said it, you called it before, you said it was probably gonna be in favor, but those two rockets will now probably give Nabbe, and he goes aggressive.
That was close.
And not sure if, you know, maybe he should have backed away for the red, but decided he wanted to go for the frag. Didn't pay off.
Well, the thing is, it's kind of the same thing as on DM4. If you have the upper hand, you want to get those spawn frags. There's a lot of frags in the world.
That's going to hurt. Mega to boot as well. Nice kill. Off conversion, fading the rocket jump one, gets the second one. Rocket to LG combo, 18-5. And what do you think the main difference has been? I know he plays aggressive, but what's Nabe's kind of downfall here? Just because he doesn't like it? What's wrong with his game?
I'd say it's mostly routine on this map. LocKtar has played it quite a lot lately, obviously. But at the same time, LocKtar has played a lot more Quake World lately than Nabbe has. I'm not quite sure. He has played a lot of TDM 4-on-4, but I haven't seen him playing duels for quite some time, so that might make a big difference.
Well, certainly it's showing on this map. 21-5. This is potentially another kill. Almost it connects with the rocket. And it does come, and these two guys showing their strengths on the map that they play. LocKtar definitely playing better on the DM4 and Aerowalk. And we'll have to see what next map will be. What would you predict it to be of Nabbe's choice?
Well, since they are going to play all five maps, it really doesn't matter that they're going to play them in game two. And I think game two or something.
Yeah, but if he loses this one, next map will maybe potentially his best map will get him a 2-2. So, DM2, and then obviously moving on to ZTN, if that is going to happen, which will be a repeat of DreamHack Summer.
CTN is in anyone's favor. I can't see any favorite on that map. DM2, though, is LocKtar's map, no question about that.
Let's see if that is going to be the map choice. 1:30 left on the clock, 26-5. And although the game's probably over, just enjoy the moment, and I'm sure LocKtar will create a few more of them, maybe in Nabbe as well. And once again, always important to finish the map off strong. If Nabbe can have a few runs, and just to say, well, you know, I could have done it as well, or maybe I've been started off a little stronger, that will send him into kind of a good mental state for at least the next map. He's going to go under pressure and give up game points to LocKtar. Conventional use of the weapon there? Or you don't see that often?
Well, that's more or less due to the pain in the ass, showing that you can shoot pretty much any weapon at your opponent. But it is actually quite efficient in a small doorway or something like that. It gives off pretty good damage.
And so, Nabbe does pick up a kill, but finally, instantly, LocKtar just comes back in and goes, no, I'll have that one back. 30-6, pretty big scoreline here. It's like they just go for explode on each other, fighting over, and it doesn't like they just like decided, let's just meet in the center. You know, no knives, and we'll fight. But it's going to be going into the last 5 seconds. 30-9. LocKtar, Nabbe actually are now holding control slightly, but that's going to be the end of the map then. LocKtar picks up the win, and it started off very, very close. It was, you know, the start of the game went over to Nabbe. You know, we saw a 4-0, 4-2 as quickly. Then we saw a 4-4. And from then on, you know, it just seemed that LocKtar found pace. You know, so I'm not sure if he just tripped up at the start of that one. But
that's usually the case in that map, or in any map for that matter. But just that you kind of like, you exchange frags for a bit. And then you get the hang of your opponent. And as I said, LocKtar, I think he has more routine on that map.
Yeah, so LocKtar definitely had Nabbe's number on that one. And we are going to go live then into the next matchup. And this is going to be match point 2, LocKtar. We're going to be moving into ZTN. Now, last time we saw these guys play this at DreamHack Summer, LocKtar went on an absolutely crazy killing spree. And we are in-game, so let's get you an in-game camera. And I'm sure we're going to bring you sound soon. But so far, LocKtar did pick up the Mega, also got the Yellow. And it sounds so silent.
Well, LocKtar actually played the Onage final against Avenger, Polish player. Didn't go too well last weekend, but he played Avenger just 1 week before that on CPN, which is Avenger's home map, and beat him, which was quite spectacular.
Nice counter, well, nice second kill there from Nabbe, actually, when he was getting pressured up the stairwell by the shaft. He actually went aggressive. That rocket was big, and LocKtar's going to capitalize. He knew it hurt, and if he comes in, he is going to pick up the frag. There will be red armor spawning soon, and he claims it. Now, he knows Nabe's gone off towards the, it looked like he went towards the LG. Maybe he backed over towards the yellow armor, so Nabbe has armor, not having all the weapons of choice, and he's only got rocket to work with. Takes a lot of damage. LocKtar still heavily in control. And look, LocKtar's actually looked like he's denying this LG quite a bit. And he once again claims the red. Mega will be spawning soon. There it is, 200-200. What can Nabbe do in this kind of situation? What do you need to do in a resident 200-200 ZTN?
You just need to back off and get that yellow armor. And first of all, you need to get that trap, since that's his strength. And just wait LocKtar out a bit. That's cool, and maybe sneak up to the red arm area and do a backstab or something like that.
Yeah, so that's the yellow pickup, and you know, giving away 7 frags from with a time when LocKtar had control, maybe not going to hurt him too much, but we'll have to see. He has now slowed down the game. Next frag will be important. If someone can pick it up cleanly, they'll have huge control. LocKtar pulls the LG out first, forces away Nabbe, and claims the red as well. Now, Mega won't be spawning. There it is. Now, Mega will spawn after he got knocked down to that 100 HP. So he's going to want to make sure that he gets the next Mega, and that's going to give him a big advantage again. Nabbe looking to spam grenades close range, and actually, I think LocKtar was kind of disappointed he had the wrong weapon out there, as he, had he known he was that close, would have put a rocket to his feet.
This map resembles Doom 4 in the sense that at the score of 8-1, as it is right now, that doesn't say much. You could get easily 10 frags within a matter of 20 seconds or something because of the spawns in the area just below red armor. So this is a fast-paced map in that sense.
Oh, and that's going to be a big frag for LocKtar because... tried trapping, but didn't work. That's a nice catch there. Catching Nabbe as he tries to cross. He's going to pick up the shaft kill, and these are the frags that we talk about. He's already picked up four, and then finds Nabbe once again, trying to get to the rocket. He does pick it up, but it's going to be the shotgun that finishes him off. And good choice of weapon there. Didn't want to risk missing that rocket shot. Knew he done enough damage. There's the red. Mega to spawn behind him soon. Checking, and once again, Nabbe is going to have to slow it down. There's the Mega, and he's got to still knock off a 200-200. Nice rocket that will shave off some of that red.
That's exactly what he has to do. He has to predict where LocKtar is going to show up and throw a couple of rockets at him before he knows it.
Giving away another frag. 14-1. Failed rocket jump by LocKtar. No, gaining speed, just flipping the edges here. And he doesn't appreciate sometimes health and armor. It seems like it comes far too often to him.
Well,
so.
I'm not sure if he wants to show off or if he doesn't use it. I think he doesn't use it, so it feels good. Just fast-paced
movement. So once again, does that actually find Nabbe? Nabbe's managed to slow it down. Let's check over with Nabbe and see what he's at. He's working with just the yellow, and you can see he's trying to camp out, catch LocKtar. He actually moved away a little bit too early. He probably potentially could have done some damage there. And trying to catch him center platform doesn't do so, but now he's got to be concerned. And that he wouldn't have done enough damage, I don't think, to force a spawn on Mega yet. So, and that yellow's gone as well. So Nabbe, if he wants to get something, he needs to get this.
Oh,
and oh, what
a nice
great
one.
Pin. And Nabbe picks up the kill. There comes a health pack to help him out. Now he desperately needs to kind of keep this control, get some frags, and he's got the advantage. Mega will be spawning. He knows it. Where is LocKtar?
Nabbe did exactly what we talked about. He waited for LocKtar to make the move, and once he just got that rocket and that shaft and peel off his armor, then it was his... advantage.
Yeah. But where's the frag going to come from? Gets forces, tries to catch round, and actually that might have just given away the red armor. He might want to spam up a rocket bit. And he's actually going to rocket jump up, and that's a good move from Nabbe. He still has armor advantage here. Now, he can defend this Mega quite well, but even defending this Mega just to pick it up isn't creating frags. So we're over half time. He's got 12 to catch up. He's going to have to head back to Mega soon.
It is frustrating to have the upper hand and still not gaining those spawn frags, which LocKtar did. So that's frustrating for Nabbe, I think.
Baiting the red armor.
And LocKtar doesn't seem to want to engage him as well, so...
LocKtar definitely not biting in this situation. There's a rocket. Is he going to force him to teleport a grenade? And LocKtar still doesn't go through. He's actually trying
there
to rocket jump away, and that's a great execution there of decisions from Nabbe. But still, once again, not getting these spawn frags. Every single frag he gets, he has to work ridiculously hard for. And LocKtar off the spawn, somehow managing to stay very elusive. He's going to come aggressive. Grenade's not hitting, and that's going to be a frag. And finally, Nabbe maybe getting a little bit of luck. There comes a conversion. Mega will be spawning. Spots him up by the grenade platform. Or at least it's called that. Yeah, it is grenade platform, at least as well in Quakeworld. Look, not a bad run there from Nabbe, but still,
Absolutely.
He needs more.
He needs to keep it cool still. I mean, he has to be aggressive, of course, but he has to keep his cool and just wait for those spawn fights to occur.
He's really hurt right now, and one rocket could be the end of him. Going to go for the health, and that would have given away red armor to LocKtar. Let's switch over to LocKtar now. You can see he's got the red. He's back in advantage, and LocKtar was he was literally invisible when he was not wanting to be seen. And now he's going to be all over the map, I'm sure.
This is not a nice situation for Nabbe at all. He's in a position where he needs to get those frags on the offensive, and there you go. Mark can just sneak up on him like that.
Took a lot of damage there, LocKtar, trying to get that kill. Actually, just stole the, looking for the axe. Not going to happen this time.
What can you expect from LocKtar? Of course he has to be.
Oh, wow. Axe. Great rocket shots, blocking the exit. And do you see any kind of like stronger weapon play from both these players?
It looks like we'll something come up for him, did they? Was LocKtar doing that for fun? What? Sorry?
Do you see any advantage in weapon play here, like a stronger rocket launcher or a shaft for either of these players?
I know that LocKtar's both his RL and his LP is really good. And from what I know, Nabbe's shop is outstanding, and that's pretty much it. So I'd say that overall, LocKtar has an advantage aim-wise.
Quake World, kind of bringing us the famous rocket launcher moments.
Yep.
Not another one there, but certainly a nice kill, and still sitting pretty on the health, waiting for the red. And LocKtar said he was on form, and definitely a matchup that proved him right, and we'll be talking to him a little bit later as we're moving into the prize ceremony after this, but still 1 minute left here of all the Quake World action that you're going to see for the remainder of the DreamHack winter. LocKtar versus Nabbe, both worthy of the final, certainly. It's great to see him back again.
I'd say that absolutely. In the semifinals, there was this game between LocKtar and DPS, which, of course, I mean, you could always speculate on if DPS would play versus Nabbe, it might turn out different. But seeing Nabbe play here, I think he's done it really well. LocKtar is so good right now, so absolutely, they're worth the finalists both of them.
And I guess you Quake guys will be going out a little bit later as well. And actually, but before that, here comes the axe.
And there it is.
And there was a frag to kind of sum up how good LocKtar was.
Well, I'm going to learn you a new Swedish word. It's called sätesbjudning, which was something what LocKtar just did.
Okay. I can't use that out, right? In the streets. Well, there we go. So there we go. And it's going to be the end then. So LocKtar will pick up the map.
And he gets the champagne from a friend of mine there. The worthy winner gets the champagne.
Serenaded. President of the LocKtar fan club down there is, you can sign up to the weekly newsletter. There are nude pictures. And certainly happy. And LocKtar happy as well.
There's actually some kind of car parts of the car he's playing on there. I'm not sure what it is, but some part of his engine.
All right. Well, if you're going to win a final and be serenaded, engine parts are a must.
It's crucial in these games, absolutely.
So we can see that LocKtar has won this one. Second time first place.
Handing over the champagne is Warson, which is a well-known figure in the Quake World scene. He has made his own Quake World trophy called the Warson Trophy, which is handed out each Quake LAN each year. For the most entertaining player, actually.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Have you ever won one of those?
No, but LocKtar did, and a few others.
All right then, so I'm going to go down and join these players, but I will of course say thank you very much, Lethal Wiz. Thanks for coming up and teaching me about Quake World. I know I play other Quakes, and I look down to Counter-Strike players. I don't know if you look down to Quake 3 players. I'm sure you do, right?
I play both Quake 3 and Counter-Strike, so I do.
All right, good. Well, there we go. So thank you so much for joining me in the commentary booth. I'm going to go down, and we will be moving into the prize ceremony momentarily.
So then, that was loud. The Quake World Finals are, of course, over. We've seen LocKtar take the victory there, and it's now time to give out the checks, which are kind of big and cool, and they've got lots of zeros on them. So third place, actually, in this tournament, who obviously lost out in the semi-finals, won his third place game, and there's obviously a lot of love here, is, of course, BPS. And unfortunately, BPS, you may have won 3,000 Swedish crowns, but we don't have a check for you, so there's a high five. Congrats.
So, worth more than
place
first place.
Is, of course, BPS. Let's give him a round of applause. Come on. Then, of course, you've just seen the final game here as well. LocKtar coming out victorious, but the man that he beat here 3-1 in maps is, of course, Nabbe, and he wins 5,000 Swedish crowns.
Well done.
You don't get a high five because you got a check. So, Nabbe, second place. And, of course, the winner here who won 7,000 Swedish crowns, second event in a row, or is it three now? It's three in a row now. Oops.
Who's counting?
A bottle of champagne as well, which is now all over the stage. Good job, guys, and his fan crew. It's, of course, LocKtar.
Well done.
Thank you. Come on, guys, get together.
So if you guys want to come forward for a photo. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your Quake World DreamHack champions of DreamHack Winter. And those checks are, you know, cashable at all good bars. So make sure you take them out. So thanks, guys. And that was it then for the Quake World Finals. I don't know if we've got anything else on stage, Joe. I think we were going to have some Quake Live, but I'm not sure if that's going to be the case.
Street Fighter 4 is next.
All right, so stick around for Street Fighter 4. We've got some beat 'em up action, if LocKtar didn't beat 'em up already. See you later. Cheers, guys.